Yeah, Darren Matches. I work in Bon Appetit restaurant, which is in Malahide, and I'm the head chef in the fine dining restaurant upstairs. Just this chef, Pierre Kaufman is his name. He's notorious and I suppose well respected and known throughout maybe older generation of chefs, maybe even older than me. And he basically trained and has made possibly the largest influence into what I would consider modern British cooking, and then as a runoff of that modern Irish food, because of his teachings and because of his method of work, like certain things he did and said and in the kitchen that would still echo true now, maybe 2 decades later, 3 decades later, you know what I mean? His famous dish, which was spoken about, is the pig's trotter Pierre Kaufman. It was then done by Marco Pierre White, which was done by, let's say, Gordon Ramsay, and it was done by Donovan Cook, and then 2-3 decades later I was able to taste it and was shown how to make it by somebody. So you have this guy who I suppose now is, he's retired, he's not on the fore, he's sort of coming back a little bit more now, but things he did I am aware of, and I suppose as a result of that it gives a bit of sort of history to what you do. He has a book out as well, it's called Memories of Gascony is a wonderful book. It's studded with recipes and techniques and methods, but it also talks about his childhood and how he grew up, and he was going and visiting his grandparents in Gascony, and he talks about, there's one image in it that sticks out for me, passing off duck fat after confying the duck legs, and the little bits of meat and skin that would fall off during the process would get stuck in the sieve as he's passing it. They'd be very crunchy, and he used to talk about eating these and memories of them at the stove. Sort of like, it does 2 things. One, it gives you a bit of history to what you're doing. And the other thing, it evokes memories similar to yours that you have had. Now, it's maybe certainly not going to be with duck fat in my background, but it would be other images and memories that you have of sharing food. That's what, you know, food ultimately is about. It's not about, we've spoken about taste and you can talk about aesthetics, but ultimately food and dining is a shared experience. You know, without that, there's nothing worse. I've eaten on my own in several restaurants, in several good places. There's nothing worse than not being able to turn to somebody else and go, did you taste that? Was that as good for you as it was for me? So without somebody to bounce off, it's nearly like it goes down to what it is, sustenance and filling, and you need it, as opposed to elevating it to an experience. That's what food is, or can be, I think, anyway. From time to time, yeah, it's a strange one, you know. I'd say it was around September, maybe, of what year would that have been? 2000. Am I getting my dates right? 2006? No, 2007. And we were aware that a Michelin inspector was coming in just by the booking and the name. He's quite notorious. Everybody knows him. He booked a table for 7 o'clock and a table for 1, which is also like red flags shooting up. You know immediately that there's a decision being made, or maybe he's just coming in and checking out. See, that's the thing with Michelin, you don't know, nothing's for certain. Their guidelines are so vague and their assessment process is so vague that you haven't a clue. But chefs being chefs, sort of half thinking we're centre of the universe half the time, we're definitely going to be in the running, you know, and that's true. Like, so we sat down anyway, or he sat down, and I still remember what he ordered. He ordered the ravioli, he ordered a lamb, and he ordered coconut parfait. It's coconut parfait with spiced pineapple. It was singly the most pressureful 45 minutes cooking. We had just opened. It was, I'm not going to say it was part of the bigger plan to get a Michelin star. It was certainly the direction we were heading in. We did not think it happened in the first year. And 3 or 4 months later it did. So after 13 months opening, having this, the head of Michelin UK and Ireland in, it was a good experience. Absolutely. It's pressureful, but it was sort of good pressure. It was like when you've, I suppose, studied for an exam and it's coming up, and instead of having that nervous, anxious feeling, you have that nervous, confident feeling. I've prepared for this. I'm ready for this. Now you want to go ahead with the challenge. It's not like, I suppose, it doesn't remind me of anything like I've done at school. It was a completely different feeling. And then obviously when the guide was published in January, we got it. So it was Absolute ecstatic. It's very good. But then, like, the next day, then you nearly forget about it. You always forget about it. I think everybody forgets about their achievements and moves on. And then you have somebody else reminding you or somebody else congratulating you. Oh, that was a great thing. And you're like, jeepers, you take a second glance at speaking to you. It's weird. It was good. I enjoyed it. Enjoyed that night, and then I enjoyed 3 or 4 months later even more. I kept the check and dated it because, you see, they're elusive. You don't know who they are, but we knew who this one was. So I took the check down and signed it. And then when he ordered pastry as well, I took that check and put both of them together. I always say, people will say to me that cooking is long hours and it's horrible and it's this. No, it's not. It's unsocial hours. You know, definitely unsocial as for what we work. Is it long? I don't think so. I do probably do about 45, maybe 50, maybe 55. Okay, for the week, the 2 weeks leading up into Christmas, then yes, it is a bit crazy. But outside that, it's not mental. The upshot of it is, but if you've an 18, 19, 20-year-old kid in the kitchen who wants to get on and shows a lot of drive, he might just have a new girlfriend. He might just want to go out with his mates on a normal Friday, Saturday night like everybody else, or go to the cinema, or like I used to do and like I want to do sometimes, but you can't. Just can't. If you do, you're putting the kitchen in under stress. You are influencing everything else that goes on, and your sort of luxury, even though it's not a luxury for everybody else, it would be a luxury for us. So it's an unfortunate aspect of it, but that's the name of the game. You don't really have any control over it, unfortunately. If you choose to take the job, that's it. The other great relationship between cooking and hairdressing, or restaurants and salons, maybe that's a bit fairer to say, is everybody gets their hair cut. Everybody goes out and gets something done. Everybody has an idea of what a good cut, a bad cut, a good colour, a negative colour, you know what I mean? And everybody eats and everybody cooks. And as a result of everybody having an influence in those two professions, they have an idea of what is right, what is wrong, what is good, what is bad. Do you know what I mean? So when somebody comes into the restaurant, straight off, they have an idea. They have a concept of what it should be like. They have an expectation. It's the same with a salon. Irrespective of their ability to do the task that they're just about to indulge into, or to be specific, irrespective of how good they would be at cooking the dish that I'm putting in front of them, they're going to have an opinion on it. And it's the same with a hairdresser. A woman can't cut her own hair, but be damned if she'll have an opinion on what the hairdresser just done. And it's the same in a restaurant. So that's the most crucial crossover, I think, because of that. We all have an opinion. But you mightn't be able to do what I do, but you'll certainly be able to criticise it because you can heat up a can of beans and add do a bit of toast. It sounds sort of as if I'm taking away from people's right to opinion. I'm not, but what I'm doing is sort of, what I'd like to do sometimes is for people to get a greater understanding of their knowledge of it and then maybe what I do. Or what is done in restaurants, I suppose. Is that a bit fairer? I think it is, yeah.